Yo, hey gang, what's going on? What's up, Manic? What's up, Eva? What's up, Satellite? What's up, RV Winkle? Hi, everybody. Happy Monday. I hope you're doing well. I've had a day. I had a bunch of stuff going. Hey, I'm not terribly late. I am, though. I had to rush to get here. I had a bunch of stuff going on today. Work stuff and other stuff. I was helping my daughter with her homework. That was a bright point. I was enjoying that. But outside of that, it was just a bunch of stuff to take care of and things. But I'm here. I made it. Hopefully work is going to be better tomorrow now that some stuff has been squared away. But we'll see. But I hope you've all been doing well. I have, up until today, been doing quite well. Yesterday, we had some folks come over. Some of my wife's old coworkers came by and had a get-together. And man, it was long. What's up, Shadows? What's up, Newhauser and Chaos? Good to see you. Folks came over at like noon and left at like 9 or 10 or something. It didn't feel like that at all. Like we had a really, really good time. Adults had a good time eating and drinking. They did one of the folks that came over is really good at making takoyaki, which if you don't know takoyaki, are these little, they're like fried balls with octopus in them that are really, really tasty. They're like they're a regional delicacy from the Osaka area. No, not Taco Bell. But yeah, so they made a whole bunch of takoyaki, and that was really nice. My wife made what's called nabe. It's a big like hot pot thing. Like stewed meats and vegetables and stuff. So takoyaki is something you've always wanted to try. It's really good. It's really good. I had it a couple times when I was in Japan, and I haven't really there are places around here that make it, but I haven't really had the chance to have it here in LA, and then having it just made here was really nice at my place. Last night I finally managed to make Star Trek in a thing again. 2 full episodes and a stupid meme posted. That sounds successful. But yeah, it was good. It was good. It was tiring. So I was kind of dragging going into work today, and then just a bunch of stuff to deal with. So, but at least I made it here. Variation is also called sukiyaki, which more people know. Wife gets you to make it for her friends. Yeah, yeah, we have sukiyaki from time to time. I think the big thing is like the soup base is different. I think the soup base is different, and you tend to add different things to them, so. Oh, right. I need to let y'all nominate. Thank God. So much stuff going on today. I totally forgot about that. Here, I'm going to open it up. Y'all don't trip over yourselves doing this. But there you go. And I guess we need to talk about that as well. A local ramen joint has takoyaki. I'm not sure how much I trust them. So I expect anything more than 1% octopus by volume. No, it should be. It should be fine. It should be totally fine. Sim Sukiyaki is partially known because that old Japanese song that I renamed is Sukiyaki here for some reason. Downloaded a bunch of NextFest demos. Well, that's the thing to do, right? Download a whole bunch of demos and then never actually play them. I do that every time. People are like, oh, Otis, you should check this out. And I'm like, okay, I think I will. And then I download it and the demo period expires. And it's one of those they take off the store outside of the demo period. I'm like, well, damn it. Vivid Loop. That's interesting. I haven't really looked at the lineup. I know there's a demo for what was it called? Radio the Universe? I think they finally have a demo out. I feel like I saw that. So they do, yeah. So this game that apparently people have been waiting for like I'm only interested in this because y'all are interested in this. A bunch of people in chat have mentioned this game, and I looked at it and I was like, ooh, that looks cool. But I don't actually know anything about the development or the team behind it. But I know there's a demo now. So you can get a taste of it, I guess. Download 2 demos, didn't end up liking either of them, but oh well. Well, that's the beauty of demos, isn't it? I feel like Steam has actually single-handedly brought demos like back into vogue, because I know that there was a period. I feel like in the early aughts, I think there was a period where companies were convinced that demos were just no good. They were just like a huge waste of time. And then I feel like Steam started bringing demos back by featuring them and getting a lot of press for the more substantial ones. And then demos started appearing more and more often on like the download services for like the Xbox and PlayStation. But yeah, I remember when I was a kid, demos were common, even though there wasn't there wasn't like a good way to distribute them. Like some games would just have demo discs like laying around stores that you could pick up for free. Sometimes they would mail them out. I would get my demos through compilation discs in PC Gamer. PC Gamer would always round up like two dozen demos or something like that and press them onto a disc and send them out with their magazine. And I played a lot of game demos that way. And then, yeah, I think as games got bigger and bandwidth didn't really keep up, I think demos started to kind of fall out of favor because it was just so hard to distribute them. And I think there was also the perception that a lot of demos hurt. They hindered sales more than they helped. Which I honestly, I don't know. That seems kind of apocryphal to me. I feel like it depends on a lot more circumstances than just the you put out a demo and statistically you're gonna do worse because of this. Like that doesn't really track with me. I think there's a lot more factors involved in that. But regardless, demos seem to be a much bigger thing now. They seem to have come back. I grabbed this demo, there's no way to get rid of the ridiculous chromatic aberration, I might not. You're saying to call it sukiyaki is something people have vaguely heard of. Usually get blank stares when I say nabe. Sukiyaki is a soury sweet taste version. Most are like savory. Ah, yeah. There was another one I tried called Takara cards, which had a lot going on. Trying to do too much. Turn-based, card-based, shmup roguelike thing that are four different kinds of research. Jesus Christ, yeah. Some games go a little too hard in trying to widen their complexity. Sometimes they go too wide. Bought Haven because the demo. I really like the Haven demo. I really, really enjoyed the Haven demo. I've got a number of things on my wish list that are on there specifically because of the demos that I played. I assume demos would hurt sales for bad games because demos would expose that they're bad. Yeah, exactly. And so maybe most games were just bad by volume. Maybe that was the issue. Tutorial for the basic combat interface and points you to a 50-page in-game manual for the rest. That's always a good sign. I don't want to harp on it too much because it was definitely put up in good faith, but I will never get over that one multiplayer game we tried that had in-game links to YouTube tutorials for its mechanics. Like the worst possible way you could try to teach your player to play your game. Like here, please leave the game and watch this like 2-hour tutorial series. That was it, Space Food Truck. Oh man. That game could be super cool if all I know, but man, they just had the worst way of tutorializing. YouTube tutorials, you say, was just looking up shortcut tutorials because I have no clue how to edit video. If YouTube tutorials are some of the best ways to learn things by choice. If you choose to go the YouTube tutorial route, then it can be a very handy way to learn something. But games, video games, should not lean on that to educate their players, especially for the in-game tutorial, because it literally becomes not an in-game tutorial. It becomes an out-of-game tutorial. And I don't like that. I'm not a fan of that. This color gives you an interesting high contrast coloring shadowing on your face. Yeah, I noticed that. I did y'all a favor, chat, because yesterday the kids that came over, they were playing with the lighting controls in here, and we actually discovered an entirely new series of lighting schemes that I didn't know about. I don't think we can use most of them. I was debating. I had this one going all day, and during the daylight hours is fine, but as you'll see, it wasn't great once darkness fell. I was debating going with this for the evening. And then I was like, wait, no, that's stupid. that's That's a terrible idea, in fact. So I will spare you this one. Yeah, but there's actually a ton just on this button. Like there's white with flashing red, which is kind of neat. It's like you're a crappy wizard. There's white with flashing blue. There's seizure mode. There's green with red. There's just blinking red. There's blinking. Yeah. So we don't need to. It makes me want to look at you even less than normal. I actually like the rave party. It would be insufferable to watch. It would be absolutely insufferable to watch. Trying to export a GIF and somehow made a 157 megabyte GIF video. Yeah, I feel like of all of those, the white base ones are probably the most tolerable. But I mean, at the same time, why not just do white? You know, the little bit of flickering light doesn't really do a whole lot for you. So the blue looks like you're in some kind of control room. It matched with my mood. I was feeling glum when I shuffled in here late. Rydell's tutorial is still the funniest shit to you, or I think it's trying to be a tutorial. All is the main character rides a bike and hard cuts to a turret sequence out of nowhere, and then QTI out of nowhere and doesn't tell you the actual gamer. What's up, not a roguelike? All my friends call me Picasso now. After playing through some again, I'm done with blue and green. Yeah, that's fair too. That is an extremely green game. It's a very saturated game in a lot of scenes. Ensign Oddish, powerize the photon fulminators. Red flashing makes it look like Oddish in a Star Trek episode after shit went down. Red alert. Well, I mean, honestly, just putting it on red is pretty intense. Like, it looks like a core is melting down somewhere. You don't even need the blinking. It's just like things have gone wrong. I like to notice straight up how Ride to Hell begins. You're given no context for it. It's amazing. I have actually seen the entirety of Ride to Hell. Long time ago. A good buddy of mine would stream games during my workday, and I would put his streams on, and we would experience games together in this fashion. And Ride to Hell was one that he played through, and I got to watch. And Jesus Christ, that's a video game. Things happen in it, but man, what a mess it is. Speaking of messes, I think we need to finish cleaning up the wasteland tonight, so I don't want to ramble too long. However, this is a very special week, so there are some things that I need to... No, it's not. There are some things that I want to make sure everybody's aware of before we launch back into Fallout 2 for the final time. The main thing is the schedule. Since we are finishing this tonight... tomorrow night, I have made the decision. I have decided, independent of all suggestions to the contrary, to play one night of Fallout Tactics. Because all I've ever played of Fallout Tactics is the demo, since we're talking about demos. As a youngin, and I was very disappointed in it, and I want to know if I'm still going to be disappointed in this game. So tomorrow night's Fallout Tactics. One night of it, one night only. So smoke if you got them, I guess. Don't worry though. I'm going to make up for it on Wednesday, because we're doing a hidden object game on Wednesday, and I promise you're gonna love this one. It's gonna be a hoot, chat. It's gonna be quite a hoot. So please show up for that. On Thursday, since I miserably failed to finish our current issue of Nintendo Power, we must do battle with Rob and George on Thursday to see the November 1992 issue of Nintendo Power closed for good, or at least as good as anything gets around here. It's been like a stream since the Democracy Less Chatting stream, and Democracy's already been subverted. And then Friday. Friday is actually the big one. Friday is the wheel. The wheel returns. And for the wheel, we are going to be exploring the Steam Next Fest. Because the Next Fest is happening. There's a whole bunch of hundreds of demos. Hundreds to actually, do they list specifically how many hundreds there are? Several, many hundreds. 838 demos in the Steam Next Fest. All I ask, chat, all I ask is that you find one that you think will be terribly entertaining for us. And you submit it using your Dragon Coins. And then on Friday, unlike with normal wheels, when I do a demo wheel, I try to play as many games as possible. So it's not just gonna be three. We're not spinning the wheel only thrice, unless we get three extremely engrossing demos. We will do at least three. So you have a much higher chance of having your pick actually played this time. So I heartily encourage you to find something interesting on here and submit it. Technically any demo on Steam is fine. It does not have to be a specifically Next Fest branded demo. That was a question in Discord earlier today. I mainly do that to avoid being inundated with like 10-year-old demos. Because, you know, it's going to be more fun to play demos of like recent and unreleased stuff than it is to like dial back to games that like everybody has in their backlogs now. So, did you play the System Shock demo yet? That's apparently it's a semi-old demo. I don't want to submit. No, I have not touched the... Yeah. I have not touched the newer System Shock stuff at all. Demo for Fallout Tactics. Let's go far, far away from that, in fact. So yeah, you're safe on that one, Shadows. You can throw that one up there and we'll give it a try. Shadows of Doubt. Avoid MMOs and avoid porn. Yeah, that's a good guideline. Yeah. I don't think there's a lot of porn demos up at I would go check, but it's probably not ideal content for Twitch at the moment. So I'll check later. I'll check on my own. Saw a few when you were skipping. Okay, yeah. Don't pick porn. Just do me a favor. Don't pick porn. PS1 demo disc. I hope my brain will let me do the next haunted PS1 demo disc. Because I know the last time, I think it was DreadX Collection 5. I couldn't actually play through because it was making me nauseous. Can I pick that big one? Sure. I don't even know what you're talking about, but go ahead. If I find a poor MMO, would they cancel each other out by multi? No, they wouldn't. They would just break things even worse. Are you really into the really popular one that's online? Are you talking about Dark and Darker? A dungeon crawler RPG PvP battle royale medieval thing? Yeah, sure. It's a demo. I have no rule against it. Pick games that are sex, but not in that sort of way. We can give it a try, sure. I don't play a lot of games like that, so it could be interesting. Hopefully, also, it's not like 30 gigs or something, but we'll see. I'll make it work. Really interesting for what you've seen. So yeah, that's Friday. And then, one more thing about this week, actually. Assuming that I don't fail to finish the Nintendo Power issue again on Thursday, on Saturday, we will finally, at long last, be starting Final Fantasy Mystic Quest. Yay! Baby's first JRPG on the Super Nintendo. I've been wanting to do this for so long. And I know that's right up some of y'all's alleys. Especially the Fallout 2 ending. I'm sure some of you nutzos are just gonna be itching for more RPG content. Well, there you go. It's gonna be on Power Hours nights. Big assumption. But a bunch of really cool looking demos. It's hard to decide which to nominate. Yeah. Yeah, I can see that. Dungeon Crawler Battle Royale, where you're looking to find as much PvE loot and avoid getting murked by other people. That's cool. That does sound cool. Isn't Baby's first RPG just Pokemon? I imagine there's quite a few people around here that would dispute that. It's actually something I could see us maybe organizing some runs on Discord. That could be cool. I would love to see... It's one of the interesting things about our community. As much stuff as we do together, like watch parties and things, I feel like we've never really had a big game that folks on Discord really came together to play, you know? There's so much multiplayer stuff out there, and maybe, you know, maybe it's just us. Maybe a lot of us are not really multiplayer-oriented people, but I'm kind of surprised there hasn't been anything that's really drawn people together to just do, like, runs of now and then. Adult babies watch a child baby game. Wait until I can maybe play a few more before I nominate. That's smart. There's enough on there that I don't think what you're interested in is going to get scooped or anything like that. Baby's first RPG for me was Mario RPG. That's because Pokemon missed me. Mine was Golden Sun. I mean, look, if we're talking about that, mine was OG Final Fantasy. I learned how to play RPGs with the original Final Fantasy. It took me until Final Fantasy II to really get what I was doing, but that's the one where I learned the basics anyway. Sounds like Tarkov meets Arx Fatalis. Oh boy. Dungeon Crawler multiplayer seems like it'd be up for Collective Valley. I would think so. But I think it's definitely gonna depend on the structure of the game and in particular how much it costs. Yeah, OG Final Fantasy is really hard. It is really hard. I basically lived out of the Nintendo Power Guide for that. As a child, I failed to understand Earthbound and Final Fantasy VII, then eventually got into Super Mario RPG. See, that's interesting to me because Super Mario... When I finally played through Super Mario RPG a few years ago, like, it was kind of rough. It had some real rough spots. It had a weird difficulty curve to it. Golden Sun and Fire Emblem 7. But yeah, Final Fantasy Mystic Quest came a little late to acclimate me to RPGs, but I had a good time with it as a kid, and I'm hoping I'm gonna have a good time with it as an adult. So start with Dragon Warrior, thanks Nintendo Power. You use that flowchart, right? You use that flowchart in issue 10 or 11. That got me somewhere. But yeah, that's the week. Lots of stuff happening. Lots of new stuff, lots of different stuff. And then, of course, I would be remiss in not reminding you to vote. There is a vote going on. It was a vote assembled by all of us together working in concert for what game we will start 1 week from tonight. That's right. No waiting, no hesitation. Whatever y'all vote in is going to be started in 1 week on, what is that day? Monday the 13th. How auspicious is that? So yeah, what do we got here? Dark Souls, Link's Awakening, Rimworld, Thief Deadly Shadows, Shire and the Wanderer, or Estatica are your options. And I heartily encourage you, to vote for whatever you want to see, because... Not all of these games are equal length. Some of them are significantly shorter than others. And depending on how preferences fall, I may prefer myself to roll directly into the second or third place game rather than start the whole democratic process again immediately. So an accurate picture of what y'all want to see in totality will help me quite a bit. Anyway, so I think that's it. Fallout Tactics tomorrow, Hidden Object Game on Wednesday, Finishing the Magazine on Thursday, Next Fest Wheel on Friday, Final Fantasy Mystic Quest on Saturday. Vote for what we start next week. Man, it's a full week. Static is a sight to behold, vote for it. Elect the next game, the next Vice game. Starting 10 minutes, we got to, I want to make sure we have time for this. I'm not worried that we're going to run out of time because if I remember this final area correctly, it's not that long. I just want to ensure. I want to be absolutely sure that we can do this tonight. So excuse me, nice synthwave music. I have video games to play. Estatica does look cool as hell. I'm genuinely interested in giving Estatica a try. It keeps getting right up there on lists, it keeps getting right to the cusp of where I'm gonna do it, and then it just, it always gets preempted by something, unfortunately. You say that, but then you're gonna play the entirety of Super Star Wars. We're not doing that again. I beat it, okay? My problem with Super Star Wars is that I hadn't beat it on stream, and I felt weird about that. So actually getting the opportunity to beat it, I could not walk away from that. I couldn't get to like the tractor beam core and be like, well, guess that's it for tonight. The space background is cool. It's the title screen from RimWorld. Which I really wish I could have played more of lately. All right, I believe, yes, this is where we left off. Okay, so, short version is fuck the Enclave. Like, seriously. If you missed last time, we rolled on down to San Francisco. We did a bunch of missions. We decided to side with the Xi over the Brotherhood of Steel. We gave them the Vertibird plans. We cleaned out the Hubologist. Fuck those people, too. The Xi helped us to get the tanker running. The only thing was we needed a nav chip. This thing. The navcom parts, excuse me. And those happened to be... I looked it up. I wanted to save us some time. Those happened to be secreted away in Vault 13. So we came back only to find everybody dead. And the security footage revealed that the Enclave showed up and cleaned out all the intelligent friendly Deathclaws because fuck them, that's why. So now we are going to go return the favor to the Enclave. The only thing is, Goris is here. Goris was left behind. And I have been thinking since last Wednesday, Goris wants to go get revenge for his lost people, and I'm thinking we should let him. The problem, of course, is that we have to leave somebody behind. And I'm thinking it may be Cassidy. I'm thinking, I wanted to pose this question to you, chat. Should we take Goris along? Should we leave Cassidy here? What are the chances the game bugs out and the ending can't be completed? I'm not expecting that to happen this time. Fallout 2 has been more stable than Fallout 1. It may be the graphical settings that I'm using on this as opposed to Fallout 1. I'm using ones that are much closer to the original, and that may be what screwed up Fallout 1 so bad. This one has had moments where it's chugged and it crashed. Like once, I think once. But other than that, it has been solid, so. No, Cassie's earned this. Cassie is trustworthy. Okay. We do have history with Cassidy. I definitely don't want to leave behind Sulik or Marcus. Who is Goris again? Goris is actually a Deathclaw. Goris is a Deathclaw scholar who just happened to be away when Vault 13 got purged. So he could have joined us earlier, the first time we came to Vault 13. But again, I am, the issue is I'm full up on party members. I have as many party members as I can take without increasing my charisma by 2 or taking a perk, which I can't because I'm 2 levels away from like the ultimate perk for this build, so. For some reason, I remembered a local retro game store back when I used to live, where they had issues with people clogging up the store on a demo system SNES. Solution they found was every so often just make the only controller connected to TurboTouch 360. That's really funny. So, PM Collector Boy, kind of interesting how the evolution of Fallout 1 to 2 to 3 kind of resembles the evolution of Arena to Daggerfall to Morrowind. You know, I hadn't thought about that, but that's a decent point. I know this would be impossible if you find out a gimmick retro night where we just make autos play SNES, NES games with weird controllers. If I could get a hold of the controllers, that would be within the realm of possibility. I say go with Goris unless Cassidy has better DPS. I'm going to stick with Cassidy. I think the fact that he's been rolling with us the whole game is a significant point in his favor. I don't think DPS is going to be an issue. I may be wrong about this, But from what I remember, I don't think it's going to be an issue. Rock and roller, rock and roller! How much ammo do I have for this thing? I have some. Hopefully I have enough. Alright, anyway. Back to San Fran. This fucking awful character, Joysticks. You always improve your DPS by taking your turns faster. Hey look, it's the edge of the map. let's go... I think we can just go straight to his hanker. I think we're all set. I think we're all set, right?
What do you want?
Let me double check real quick. Make sure everybody's armed up. That's the Avenger. Oh yeah, he's only a super power fist, that's right. We're gonna bring the Gek to my people. Yeah, I'm pretty sure we're fine. Okay, so we need to get down to... We need to get over here. I forget where's the best place to go down. I think there's only like one or two Wanamingos hanging out down there. We should be okay, question mark. Well, there's one of them. There are many. Did they respawn? There's... Why is there five? Come on, man. I don't want to fight Wanamingos. Fallout 1 and 2 are interplay? Yes. Created by Black Isle and published by Interplay. I was about to say, they don't seem very inclined to actually attack me. That was weird. Hopefully I can just punch them to death. Oh, there's two of them down there that saw me. Don't go for Cassidy! All right, that actually really helped, damn. Yeah, that's it, just punch the shit out of him. They should be in the bait cast. All right, nothing I can do from this far, so. Let him close in. Well, okay. Marcus hit for 10. Spirits be helping me now. Oh, that's right. Cassie has a Tommy gun. Just kill him, dude. Just end his shit. Yeah, I'm one to talk. Okay, well, that's one dead. What's up, Loader High? Yes! It's a demo wheel this week. I've taken worse in practice. Blacker, 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 blacker. Oh, okay, so they were both hit for no damage. Okay, I gotta switch him back to the shotgun. I think the Tommy gun was actually a mistake. Are you committing to a full playthrough winning game? Of course not. What a ridiculous question. I don't know what you're angling for, but it's not gonna work. All right, I gotta take this Tommy gun away from him. He's gonna get us all killed. Splap, splap. Don't do it. Oh wow, that actually worked out. Except just didn't do any damn damage. Damn damage. Shoot right in your stupid alien dome. Yeah, you heard me. You heard me. What? Thank you. Mm. Excellent. All right. End combat. 2800 experience is really nice. Cassidy! I need to talk to you about your gear. Put your weapon away. Combat. No, no, no. Combat control. Trade. Yeah, because you got it. Dude, you're holding a fucking Pancord jackhammer. That's what you need. That's what you should be using. Give me that. There we go. Is it? I thought I had better armor for him than the Bridgekeeper's robe. Oh, I gave him Metal Mark too, but I guess that's not, I guess that's not good enough for him. That's fine. I think the only thing left is probably there's a floater around here, but that's fine. I'm not too worried about that. A friend of mine is looking through the Steam Next demos, is currently low key stressed by a demo for an IT technician simulator because he works IT. Well, maybe it's like unpacking, where like it's something that inherently makes everybody like super super anxious, but actually ends up being really really fun. Oh, you guys are gonna piss me off, aren't you? You guys are really gonna piss me off. Yeah, I know. I need to stall the fucking navcom. Dipshit. Here, have it. Navigational computer online, log off. Great. No, 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 cat. No, no, cat. No, yes. I kind of wonder if, like, no. I kind of wonder if maybe they designed this part of the game before realizing you were going to have companions or some shit. Because this, like, idiot conga line is so stupid. And yet, technically, I think it's still faster than having to talk to each individual one of them, telling them to wait, waiting for the interface to slide up and down, leaving, coming up here, doing the thing, going back, and then talking to them again to tell them to come along. This being so far as this was like to play Euro Truck Sim when you're actually a trucker. All right, so that's done. I think I'm gonna run back into town too, after we're done down here, and heal up at the dock. Just shoot them, they know what they did. You got in my way. By the way, how close am I to the next level? All right, I am 10,000 off from the next level. I do not know how much experience we're gonna gain in the Enclave base. Hopefully it's enough to hit level 24 by the end. I think possibly, maybe. No, that's fine. That's right, the docks have slowdown. I can skip it though. I know how to skip it. I'm a smart person. I'm a clever boy. The docks over here. Doctor, I should say. I just came from the docks to go see the dock. The good old days and everything was at right angles. I need healing. How much? Oh, I need my friends healed. Does he not do that? thought he did. I must have healed up somewhere else. Shit. Because I don't need healing. I'm at 114 of 115. Sulik is unhurt. Cassidy is wounded. That's not too bad. Where's Marcus? We leave Marcus somewhere. Marcus! Marcus! There he is. Jesus Christ. Marcus is severely wounded. Watching Sivvy's video on Unreal and got reminded of how good that bit where you first climb out of the opening ship and see the planet for the first time is. I still remember that. That was real cool. As flawed as Unreal can be, I think that scene is still one of the best sequences in PC games. I'm gonna bring my M60 just because. Just to make sure I don't run out of... Yeah, because I've still got 100... I've still got 100 pounds of leeway. So I'm gonna go around like so. Go back to tanker this a ways. All right, I think all we gotta do is talk to the captain, and we're ready. Over the sea, let's go, men. Shoving right off, we're shoving right off again. Na 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 na. I think we just push the go button. Let's see here. Upside another terminal limited. Check status. Fuel tanks full. Cargo hold empty. Navigation functional. Mooring lines attached. Can we go? I think we're going. Oh, cutscene chat. The old beast whirs to life. All ahead full. Don't worry about the moorings. they're fine. It's fine. It's fine, chat. They weren't using those. Can you hear that song without thinking Bugs Bunny screaming with Daffy and Duckamuck? That's the only reason I know that song. That is literally where I got it from. Okay, more or less. I legit wonder the scene in Halo 1 where you first step on the Halo ring was inspired by the reveal of the planet in Unreal. I could see that. Unreal had a huge impact on the industry. You know, we talk about Half-Life and we talk about the Quake games, but Unreal had a really big impact too. Like, no lie. It was a very influential game. Check it out, chat. We appear to have arrived somewhere. Docking complete, target reach, nav comp disengaged. Welcome to the Enclave. We're here. We've gone up a level. We gained 15,000 experience for getting here. Holy shit, that's a lot of experience. Goddamn. All right, so we are 17,000 away from the next one. Unreal 2 also had an impact that nobody wanted to make anything like it ever again. Unreal, how much of an impact it had. I am going to... Let's see. How do I want to do this? Cutscene was hella cool. I know, 3 Mile. Wasn't it sweet? Let's throw some extra into speech, just because I feel like it might be useful. And then a point. A point in... I don't know. An extra point in small guns. Who cares? All right, well, let's save real quick. Epic delisted all the Unreal games. Fortunately, I still have them. I bought them on Steam before they all went away. You see nothing out of... No, I'm pretty sure I see something out of the ordinary. I think this is pretty out of the ordinary. Hello! Hi! Okay, well, we haven't been mulched yet, so that's good. It's the Enclave's floor. What's this? Bomb beside net, enter menu selection, log on, list users, terminal displays a list of about 500 names. It looks kind of special. Presidential passkey security override. Maybe I'll try this later. I know what that's for. All right. We got some stairs down. And we've got an exit thing over here. Can I open this? Does this open? Okay, that opens. Does this open? There's an old ad copy for Unreal. It's called Unreal because it is. It's like legit, yeah. Well, that's not what I wanted. I just got hit for a bunch of shots. That's not at all what I had in mind. Hang on. Okay, if I... Hang on. If I come in here solo, if I come in here by myself, will they not shoot me up? Since I'm wearing Enclave power armor? Or maybe I do need to screw around with that console.
What you be needing? This look like a good place to sit back for a bit.
You ever played Unreal 2? To be honest, I'm gonna admit I'm kind of curious about it. Because I don't usually hear that unified vitriol against games, so I'm curious what caused it.
What do you want?
I have seen a bit of it.
Stay here and tighten the vices on my shoulder.
I have seen a bit of it. I haven't played it myself. I know why it's bad. Never heard of Unreal 2 Defenders. I don't think they exist. I genuinely don't think they exist. Okay, so you're not gonna shoot me, right? Okay, this is what we need to do. All right. Sneaky, sneaky. Why aren't you punching people or things into the ground? Because this would... Okay. This is really where the limitations of the Fallout combat system come into play. I really don't want to have to kill everyone in here. I really, really, really don't want to have to shoot it out just because the mechanics of it would take fucking forever. Also, you get some really interesting dialogue in here. See a person in a vault suit. Holodeck clear. This is the end game. This is I guess what you would consider the final dungeon. It's past this run anyway. What are you? I'm a person in power armor, obviously. The project is our salvation. The project. Ominously named. Passive fist run. Don't worry. There is going to be fighting. Don't you worry about that. It's just, we don't need to be throwing down with a room of like a dozen power armor dudes, okay? It'll be fine. Everybody's just a person in power armor. Can I go raid your stuff? Can I go have a bunch of your equipment? Well, there's power armor. There's just some power armor hanging out in there. There's some cells. I'm mainly just looking for bullets for my current gun. Well, these are bullets for somebody's gun. Those are missiles. I never did get a rocket launcher. Hey, these filthy neutrals with enemies, you know where they stand with the neutrals. Who knows? Oh, hey, it's a rocket launcher. Give me a rocket launcher. That could come in handy. It's a lot of rocket launchers, in fact. A lot of rocket launchers. Plasma rifle. Totally guessed you were getting a rocket launcher. That's a laser rifle, I think. Actually, I haven't seen too many of those, strangely enough. And an Avenger, which we already have. How am I on weight? I could actually carry that around, but what I really want is rockets. Plus, how bad does the commute have to be for someone to bring the rocket launchers and power armor to work? We'll take those. Take these. Might as well take some plastic explosives too. You never know when those are gonna come in handy. I've still got a threshold of like 50 pounds of stuff, which should be all I need, I think. Ah, I actually wanted to go through there. This guy is... Okay. This guy's just sitting here singing along. He's got a song in his heart. Never know when you need to use some explosives on a stuck kitchen door. Exactly. It's all just persons in powered armor. Let's go downstairs. You see no way in which to open the door. Okay, well, let's save. When that jar just will not open. Keep on keeping on. They actually said keep on keeping on back in the late 90s. I have no memory of that. Is there a terminal around here that would open that? Like a security room or something? There's showers, there's barracks. Maybe this is, you know what? Maybe this isn't where I want to go. Maybe I want to go the other way. Okay. Keep on keeping on was from the 70s. That's interesting, because I feel like I only really heard it like in the last decade or something. Maybe it's one of those turns of phrase that made a comeback. Y'all are fine. Would have been boomer speak even back in the 90s. Hello! God, that makes me nervous every time it happens. That's still an Avenger. Another one over here. And I found a group of- here we go, Vindicator! I have discovered the Vindicator minigun. This is the endgame minigun. The German Rheinmetall AG company created the ultimate minigun. The Vindicator throws over 90,000 caseless shells per minute down at 6 carbon polymer barrels. Has a pinnacle of Teutonic engineering skills, the ultimate handheld weapon. It fires 4.7 caseless. Okay, so I need, and it weighs 30 pounds. Okay, so I need to find 4.7 caseless. Which is, no, that's 2mm EC. Which is, I was wrong. That's 4.7. It's the stuff that Sulik's been throwing around. So I'm gonna unload this. And I'm gonna load this. And I'm gonna hoover up as many of these bullets as I can. You can finally vindicate yourself. I shall be vindicated. All right. I think we're going in here. All right, there's some operations going in here. Researcher. Computer, machine. I see the elder of our village. Glum person in a vault suit. People in powered armor. Okay. This guy looks important. Okay. Forgot a locker. Did I forget a locker there? No, they're all open. Okay, I think there's a clever person way to do this. Enclave trooper. Do they say things? It's not. Cannot get there. I bet I can speak to my elder, though.
Chosen one.
Hi.
How did you get here?
I've come to rescue you.
Careful. Do not touch the glow wall. I think the machine that feeds it is beneath us. Destroy it so we may escape. How did you get here?
I have a ship.
If you destroy the machine, we will find the ship. Hurry. There are not many of us left.
What happened?
Men came to our village in flying machines and took us. There were others too, from the Holy 13. I thought we were saved. I thought we were going to heaven.
And then?
Then they brought us here, to hell.
To hell.
They have killed most of us with something they call FEV. They will kill us all before they are through. Do you know what must be done, Chosen One?
Yes.
You must destroy the machine and kill the devils in this place. We will meet you outside. And Chosen One, if you have not found the Geck, seek it here. Our freedom is nothing if we cannot save our village. Now go.
I guess it's a good thing I've had Marcus carrying around the Geck this whole time. I guess that was smart. Alright, I can't talk to them. That's probably sealed. Let me go see if this researcher is anything special. Because he definitely looks important. Except now he ain't even there anymore. Oh, there he is. Are you anybody? Do you matter? Can't you see I'm working? Okay. He doesn't matter. So this is a very big area, but also not a whole lot to interact with unless you are interacting with bullets. Okay, down here we have, are you for real with this shit? Oh my God. Did you flip the self-destruct switch and leave again? Bunny, you should mention that. All right, this is some stupid bullshit here. The floor here is electrified for some reason. In here. Hi guys. What's crack-a-lackin'? You have some cool stuff I can have? I like cool stuff. That's 2mm EC. This is a Gatling laser, which unfortunately is an energy weapon and not a heavy weapon. What the fuck? Oh, M72 Gauss rifle. This, I believe, is the endgame small arms weapon. What does this use? 2mm EC? I could steal this for Sulik, actually. That would be helpful. Possibly. How are we doing on... Okay, we're getting close to capacity here, but I don't think there's a whole lot else I want to carry other than 4.7 caseless, maybe. The Gauss rifle, the small arms weapon. The distinction between... Oh, here's another... Oh, Advanced Power Armor Mark II. Okay. I would like that a lot. I would... Oh, if I take this off, I'm gonna die. If I take this off for even a second, I'm dead. I think what I can do... Hang on. Don't lie to yourself, Sulik. We'll try to use this as a sword or a spear. Let me put a bunch of really heavy shit in here so I can carry this, and then I can just flip it directly. Did that work? Okay, it's in. Okay. Like, nothing happened. That guy was even watching me do that. That guy just watched me change. And was like, this is fine. That increase... No, I'm like at capacity now. I like super stims. Give me that. Is terminal gonna do anything useful? Log on. Enter user ID. List users. One is okay access. Security status. Turn to user ID. Okay. Are you even on the radar as a person? I feel like they don't know who you are. I mean, they may not, actually. They may not know the relevance of me. Hang on, I'm gonna wait for this electrified floor discharges prompt again. Up there, okay, there it went. So we should be able to run straight across now to whatever the hell this room is. Survival gear locker. I think the thing is though, if I just stripped off my armor in front of them, they would see like the Vault 13 jumpsuit. And I think they probably know enough about what's going on to know that that's not right. There's a flamer. A plasma rifle, nice. All right, electrified floor discharges. That's not what I wanted. Ow! Well, I'll take less damage from that now, that's good. That's not what I wanted either. This is so stupid. This is so stupid. All right, some things opened, but not the things that I needed to open. All right. I feel like I'm kind of back to square one here. I tried this one. These bottom three doors are not opening. Okay, so that zaps you. Hang on. That opens that door. Nothing opens those bottom three doors. That closes all three of those doors. For whatever reason, I can't repeat use them. Ow! There, that opened that one. Okay, except now I'm fucking trapped in this room. That's great. And that made different doors open. What the fuck? That made different doors open and close now. Did that? No, that didn't. And that, fuck, that made that one close. Okay. Those are open now. Okay, that's open now. Okay, wait. Progress, perhaps? I totally forgot about this. I can't believe they put fucking door puzzles in this. I hate it so much. Okay, I can get into this room now. Oh my god. Okay. Except that door is closed? What the hell? Okay, I think we're out of here. I knew they forgot the geck. I wonder if one might be around here somewhere. They won't let you. Okay. All right, that's fine. They won't let you leave without the gag. There's gotta be one in here. Yep, there it is. Paramedics bag, first aid field kit. What am I carrying that I'm not gonna want anymore? Honestly, I think I'm good on weapons. I'm gonna leave them 60. Okay. I'm gonna use another one of these. Cause yeah, I've got the Bozar, the Vindicator, and a rocket launcher now. I should be fine. Now you have two geks. I wish I had remembered you had to carry one down, because then I could have just taken the one from Marcus. It would have been fine. They literally won't let you through there unless you have a Gek. Okay. All right, down the stairs. You lived through the puzzle rune. I gained experience. I'm a genius. I'm so smart. Okay, well, this looks important. So it sounds like as long as we deactivate the force fields, our people can somehow just magically escape. My sprite's messed up. I hope that's not gonna be an issue. What else is on this floor? Scientists. Very tired looking man in a white coat. Okay. Researcher. This is a nuclear bomb. It looks very dangerous just sitting there. I think this is literally the same kind of nuclear bomb that was in the basement of the cathedral in Fallout 1. These are stairs back up, I think, to the detention block. This is a war room table. There's some very official looking people over here. I think we should probably go see if we can talk to the official looking people. But first, any more neat stuff in here? People don't seem very bright, so I believe they let prisoners out and just assume someone meant to let them out. I know, right? Let me talk to... There's a science man. I want to talk to science man. Man of science. Who's this? You look kind of important. What's this? Oh, there's stairs even further down. It's interesting. Science man! Welcome to the chemical core section, Trooper. I'm Lieutenant Colonel Dr. Charles Curling. Now that we've been introduced, get the hell out of my lab. I'm not who you think I am. I am Larry from Arroyo, and we've got something to talk about. Well, Larry, I don't know how you escaped your cell, but I don't think we have anything to talk about. That's where you're wrong, a couple times. You talk to me? Who are you and why should I spend time talking to you? I'm Larry, you better talk to me because I'm holding all the aces here. The final resort of me, all tiny mind primitive, is so easy to see what separates you from real humans like us. You're so damn sure of yourself, aren't you? Shouldn't I be? Our research on the villagers clearly shows changes to their DNA. It's a natural result of all the background radiation. So what if our DNA is a little different? Oh, your DNA is more than just a little different. It's quite different. If I weren't so pressed for time by the project, I'd be interested in running further tests on your people. Other than the FEV toxicological survey study, of course. Fascinating work, really. How is our DNA different? There are a number of primarily very subtle changes. I haven't had the time to look at the ramifications of the changes yet, though. Also, I have to backtrack to isolate your initial gene stock where I could hazard any ideas on the direction the changes are taking. All in all, though, the information is clear enough. What information? Why, the information that you and your tribe are no longer human, of course, since your tribe has only been out of the vault, let's see, Vault 13, wasn't it, for some 80-odd years. Anyone out longer is certain to have been even more compromised. Yes, I'm afraid the conclusion is unavoidable. What conclusion? I thought I made myself perfectly clear, the conclusion that you and all your kind are no longer human. In order to retake the Earth and to maintain the integrity of the human race, all you mutants will have to be destroyed. What do you mean? The project that the Enclave has dedicated itself to these past several decades has been the reestablishment of the human race upon the continental United States. God bless America. That doesn't sound as though it would take decades to achieve. Oh, just establishing an outpost wouldn't take long. We've already done that in Navarro, but it's taken a long time to work out the proper method for the eradication procedure. What? But yes, we can't move back to the mainland only to risk contamination by all the mutated near humans there. In order to make the United States safe for humanity, all of the mutants must first be exterminated. How are you going to do that? The FEV toxin. It's the perfect solution for this difficult problem. What's that? Well, our patrols found the research data and several samples about the FEV virus in a former military research base that had been almost completely destroyed. Okay, now I know where you found it, but what does it do? The FEV was initially designed as a virus that was supposed to turn humans into super soldiers. That experiment seems to have been an utter failure. Although I did try a modification of the virus on one of our Secret Service agents with some success. Great for you. How does that have anything to do with eradicating everyone? Oh yeah, well, I was getting to that. The FEV virus bond is species-specific. It will only bond with human glycoproteins. It only took a few years to tweak the FEV virus to make it more lethal than it already was. The result was just what the doctor ordered. Perfect in every way. Isn't it obvious, my mutated friend? The FEV is, thanks to me, a lethal toxin, and thanks to some mysterious genius named, rather dramatically, the Master, it only works on humans, mutated or not. So? That means we have the perfect disposal device for all of the near-human mutants infecting the globe. I still don't understand how that's perfect. The FEV toxin will only attack humans, leaving everything else alive. Better still, within a month, all the mutants will be dead, and the FEV toxin will die out as soon as it runs out of hosts. There can't be enough vertebrates here to spread the toxin all over the globe. You're right, there aren't, but we don't need them. We have a release system that will spray the FEV toxin straight from the vats to the outside atmosphere. The jet stream will take care of the rest. Global saturation within 2 weeks. 2 weeks for the virus to spread, another month or so for it to run its course, and then the United States will be ready for recolonization by real humans. Our species will have been saved. You really think you're doing the right thing, don't you? Yes, I do. There is no price too high to pay for the survival of one species. I'd agree with you on that. Has it occurred to you that the mutants, as you call them, are just another type of human? I didn't even stop to think about it that way. Please, give me a minute while I think this over very carefully. That's okay. Take your time, Doctor. It's a big concept to swallow. I hate to admit this, but you may be right. What we've been planning all along just isn't right. I was so blinded by trying to overcome the obstacles that I didn't think about the morality of my quest. I feel like this might be a good time to mention. I get the impression that the later areas of this game might have been a bit rushed. San Francisco and the Enclave base in particular seems like maybe there was supposed to be more to it than what ended up being in here. Now that you thought about it, you should destroy the toxin. No, that wouldn't work. Why not? They'd just start over. Even with me dead, there's enough data between here and Navarre to assure that they could replicate my work. Only something more drastic will be enough. What do you mean? The Enclave must be destroyed. Completely destroyed. If we're not, then we'll pick up the pieces and start over somewhere else. Okay, I get it. Wait, chat. This is entirely consistent with this character. This guy is bound and determined to do a genocide. All he wants in life is to do a genocide. And the Enclave was like, you should do a genocide on mutants. And he's like, okay. And then we showed up and we were like, no, don't genocide mutants. And he's like, oh, shit. How about the Enclave? And we're like, yes. Yes, this is what we'll do. Damn it. Legio Necris, thank you for the raid. You've shown up at a pinnacle moment where we've basically just convinced Goebbels of the error of his ways. You're doing those blade radioactive pools. America needs to start fresh and new with real humans. Oh, wait, no, that's bad. America needs to start fresh by killing real humans. Sorry to hear that. Doctor, how do you suggest the Enclave be destroyed anyway? I think the best way is to just release the FEV toxin into the air filtration system. Since the Enclave is a sealed system, that should take care of everyone. What about my people or me or you for that matter? I can release the antidote in the air system for all the cells. The detention level is served by a separate air system from the rest of the Enclave. Everyone will think that I'm just running another test. You, I can inoculate directly here and now. Okay. Ouch. Thanks, Doc. What happens when the FEV toxin is released? It's not pretty. You should leave as soon as possible, but I'd rather have the weight of 1,000 on my conscience than several hundred thousand. Our time is through here. We've had our chance. How can I free my people from the detention area? You should probably shut down the power. I know the reactor is controlled by a large computer near the reactor bay, but I don't know exactly what you need to do to shut the reactor down. Thanks for the information you give me. Your sacrifice will be remembered by all the peoples of the Earth. When the stars threw down their spears and watered heaven with their tears, did he smile his work to see? Did he who made the lamb make thee? Just something I remembered from a long dead poet. I was wondering if there's still a place for those who worked such a dark end for so long. Our time is over. Yours has just begun. Get going. Oh, you're playing Impossible Creatures. Nice. I have never played that one before. Yeah, that game definitely looks rad. Thanks for all your help. You're a brave man. Okay. William Blake? I couldn't tell you. I don't know. Look, I see this is stupid plot resolutions in my day, but yeah, it's kind of, it's a bit much, isn't it? I don't think that's all, though. I think there's more to be did. I think we're just getting started. Warning, toxins will be released into air ducts. Hang on, let me see if I actually have time to talk to these other dudes. Let's see. I think we want to get in here. Osh doesn't know poets unless they're American poets. Writing stanzas about fried chicken, how many secrets, herbs, and spices they have. This is a small, nervous-looking man. Hello, Trooper. What are you doing in the Vice President's office? The what? I'm Vice President Daniel Byrd. Damn glad to meet you. You're just another part of the whole problem here. I am not part of the problem. I am a Republican. Like I said, part of the problem. That's not true. Republicans understand the importance of bondage between a mother and child. That's the key to the solution of all of our problems. We need a return to family values. Bonus points if you know who this is supposed to be. What you and the Enclave are up to has nothing to do with family values. I stand by all the misstatements that I've made. Don't you understand you'll create another Holocaust if you continue? The Holocaust was an obscene period in our nation's history. I mean, the century's history, but we all lived in this century. I didn't live in this century. Okay, Manic knows. Okay, chat, Damn, all right. Some of you are not gonna believe this. Some of you are probably young enough to not believe that this really happened. So this guy is supposed to be Vice President Dan Quayle, the senior Bush's vice president. All of these lines, I wish I was making this up. All of these lines are things he actually said. If you're wondering why our dialogue is so weird here, it's because we're teeing him up to give the actual quotes that Dan Quayle said. You're a flippin' loony. What a waste it is to lose one's mind, or to not to have a mind is being very wasteful. How true that is. Was he a good... was he a good VP? No. No, he was not. Emphatically no. Dan Quayle was picked as vice president specifically to protect Bush from assassination attempts because no one wanted him in the big seat. He was definitely a vice president. What the hell did you just say? Tell me, how do you spell potato, with an E or without? Without, of course. Perhaps that's best. Keep it brief. After all, verbosity leads to unclear, inarticulate things. Imagine that. Well, you can't be too careful. After all, people that are really very weird can get into sensitive positions and have a tremendous impact on history. Wait, what impact are you planning to have on history? I see. Well, as you may know, I've long thought that it's time for the human race to enter the solar system. Aren't we already... Wait, to go where? I think that maybe Mars would be nice, because Mars is essentially in the same orbit. Mars is somewhat the same distance from the sun, which is very important. We have seen pictures where there are canals, we believe, and water. If there is water... God, Christ, the more I read this, the more he sounds like Trump. This is really starting to fuck with my brain now, too. If there's water, that means there's oxygen. If there's oxygen, that means we can breathe. Yeah, he's Republican. I didn't expect such a complete answer. Of course you do, of course. Any loyal citizens of these great United States would do the same. Why is that? We have to work together because if we don't succeed, we run the risk of failure. I can't fucking believe the Republican jokes I made earlier came true. This game is a masterpiece. Quayle was not as intelligent as Trump. Trump is more evil. God, isn't that just a horrible thought? That there's actually people out there that are dumber than Trump. I would not be surprised by anyone nowadays who didn't get the reference. There are too damn many Republicans who sound like this now. That's the other thing. Yeah, it didn't even occur to me. I was like, oh, lol, funny quotes from stupid Republican man. And then I was like, wait, this sounds really familiar. And not because I remember this from history. This sounds like in the last few years recent. I feel like Trump knows better but doesn't care where Quayle didn't know better. I can see that, yeah. I can see, like, Quayle was just... Quayle was in large part, like, just hopelessly naive and just really, really uneducated in a lot of basic things. Trump does know a lot of things and just chooses to spurn it because he's just that big a shithead. Well, I better be going now. Carry on, Trooper. The future will be better tomorrow. Yeah, whatever. Goodbye. I think you just get it stuck in like a dialogue loop with that guy if you don't do anything else. Okay, so that's done. So that's the vice president. Who do you suppose this is? See a man in a suit, he's staring to space like he's looking at you, but he ain't looking at you.
Well, hello there. Glad to make time for one of our gallant troopers, but I am rather busy, so what can the President of the United States of America do for you?
You can tell me just what's going on here.
You really don't know, do you? Let me tell you about mankind's salvation. A little history first.
Go on, Mr. President.
There was a great war, long before we were born. Our gallant soldiers fought from the Yukon to the Yangtze.
Yeah, I know that part. Go on.
We were winning, too. And then those damn Reds launched. We barely got our birds up.
Doesn't seem as though it helped us much.
Well, no, it didn't. But at least it knocked the damn Red menace back into the Stone Age.
And us with it.
Well, no, not quite. You see, we had planned ahead. We were ready.
That smarmy look after every fucking line. What do you mean?
We had a number of sanctuaries that would enable the glorious American civilization to endure. This facility, the vaults, were part of the great plan.
I'm noticing that his text dialogue and his VO doesn't actually match up. The text is only referring to the vaults, but in his VO, he's referring to the Enclave rig and the vaults as separate entities. Damn vaults didn't work the way they were supposed to. A lot of people in them died.
Actually, they worked almost exactly the way they were supposed to. You might call it a social experiment on a grand scale.
I think we were talking about this at the beginning of Fallout 2. People were wondering if the whole thing about vaults being purposely faulty was a thing that Bethesda came up with. An experiment.
The vaults were set up to test humanity. Some had not enough food synthesizers. Others had only men in them. Yet others were designed to open after only 6 months. They each had a unique set of circumstances designed to test the occupants.
What about Vault 13? What was its purpose?
Vault 13 was a special case. It was supposed to remain closed until the subjects were needed. Vault 13 was, in scientific parlance, a control group.
But they would have all died if my ancestor didn't get them a replacement water chip. That doesn't seem to fit in with your plan.
An unfortunate and unforeseen accident. However, as it turns out, a rather fortuitous one.
This guy just completely glossed over that we're related to the Vault Dweller, that we actually know what's going on here. What do you mean?
As it turns out, we needed test subjects from untainted pre-war human stock, your ancestors in Vault 13, and some freshly mutated stock, the villagers from Arroyo.
Why?
For the project. It's almost ready. Humanity's salvation is almost at hand, and the United States of America will be the progenitor of that rebirth.
What do you mean?
The only way for true humans and democracy to democracy. Be safe is to cleanse the mutants from the globe. We humans will take back that which is rightfully ours.
I'm a true human, too.
I'm sure you think so. But tests performed on your tribesmen have all shown that you are guilty of mutation. And it's a damn good thing the project is ready.
Guilty of mutation? Why?
Some of the members of your tribe are showing some extremely interesting changes. If the danger to true humanity weren't so great, I would think about studying them, but that's not to be.
Isn't he a Republican? Doesn't he hate democracy? Yes, but he's still... This one, at least, is smart enough to know that you have to dog whistle. He's not going to straight up say, I hate democracy. He's going to go in on shutting down polling places and the like. Why does he just build a wall around the oil rig?
The project will cleanse all the mutants from our fair land and the rest of the globe. Once again, America will be the world's policeman.
And we know what to do with policemen, don't we, Chad? Sounds a bit drastic. How are you going to do that?
We found a research facility in operational shape about 70 years ago. A former fraudulent military base that had been used to research a special virus.
Sup, Smeck Thing? How you doing? You're just in time for the epic conclusion of Fallout 2. What's good? Oh, you know, just talking to the President of the United States.
Yes, the FEV virus. It was originally developed to turn soldiers into super warriors, but it failed. The warriors were tough and strong, but far too stupid. However, our brilliant chemical core altered it to turn it into a staggeringly effective
killer. We already got
this
from the scientists who already switched sides.
That isn't inoculated against its effects before its release will die. That is the project.
That's insane.
No, that's humanity's last best hope. That's what we've been working towards all these years.
He's Republican, you pay him $20,000 to not do the project. I would have to set up a super PAC first. Great, you have all this poison, no way to spread around.
But that's one of the advantages of the FEV virus. We can release it right here, and the jet stream will carry it worldwide. It'll have plenty of time to cleanse every nook and cranny of the globe.
Okay, then why'd you have to kidnap my villagers and the people from Vault 13?
Test subjects? Your villagers are all descended from Vault stock, and we had to make sure that the FEV toxin was still effective. The subjects from Vault 13 test that, and an inoculation against the FEV.
You're not testing the inoculation on my people?
It's hardly necessary. I'm sure we could, and it would work, but there's no reason to do so.
Did she? Here we go, chat. Here's our big moment. Did it ever occur to you that what you're doing is wrong?
Never. Part of the president's job is to make the tough decisions. A lot of near humans will sacrifice their lives for the return of humanity. Humans will prevail.
Just because everyone out there doesn't have an exact copy of your DNA, that doesn't give you a license to exterminate them.
Oh, I don't relish this decision. If there was another way, but there isn't. No price is too high for the survival of the human race. If you were human, you'd feel the same way.
You really believe that, don't you?
Yes, I do. Even killing me won't help you. There's nothing you can do to stop the release.
We'll just see about that. I got things to do. Goodbye, President Richardson. Who is this? Who is this? Okay. Severely poor taste joke there. My lungs are on fire. Can we kill him? He's dead anyway. Don't worry. The release of the toxin into the air vents is gonna kill him. If we kill him, everyone in this base is gonna aggro on me, and we don't need that right now. We are already in good shape. This is, where the fuck is this? Falling man, a lab coat. Ah. Huh. Computer mainframe. Thought the inoculated would be safe. Isn't he inoculated? No, they've been testing it. They haven't administered the inoculation to anybody yet. They've only been testing it, which is why the doctor wanted to release the FEV internally instead of externally, because that will kill the Enclave. Let's see. I think we'll just save over this stuff. All right, I gotta break some things. I don't know if the computer console will let me do that, but. Researcher. Yes, I know my sprite's messed up. Don't worry about that. I'm sure it's fine. I'm sure everything is fine. That's also a researcher. How the hell do I get into this room? Is there further stairs down or something? Doesn't seem like it. But to be improved, we got the Wolfenstein 3D instant replay on the president's death like we got with Hitler and Wolf 3D. There is a name, like, not a named guy, but there's a guy with a slightly different description. You see Tom Murray, the head of the Atomic Energy Commission. Okay, stay calm. What's the alarm ringing about? I love my work. Okay, that's great, but I need to break some stuff, and I'm not entirely clear on how to go about that. We got some computer consoles. I think I need to get into this room, but I'm not sure where you can do that from. Unless there was an elevator on the upper floor that I didn't notice. There's a turret down there. It doesn't help me. Is there an elevator over here somewhere? That's the stairs I came down on. These are the toxin tanks, I think. Whoa, somebody just died. What was that? Who was that? Citizen was hit for 100 hit points and was killed. Oh, I think they're gonna start dying off now. Yeah, the FEV is starting to kill people. Oh, yeah. So I think I need to go down there. But I don't know what to do down there is the problem. There goes Scientist Man. Oh, these guys are actually carrying stuff. Science these consoles? No. I have a lot of science. What's happening to these people? The FEV virus that was released into the air ducts is killing them all. It's exactly what the researcher guy said would happen. Very violently, apparently. Fuck them. Do any of these computers do anything different? No. Any of this stuff down here? No. I'm gonna look this up real quick because I'm not really sure where I'm supposed to go from here. This is the one where you can prank call the main villain at some point. I don't actually know. Not that one. Here we go. Okay. No. The main villain is indeed America, yes. Hang on one sec. Mm-mm-mm. Okay, I got it. I got it. Let's see. Just to be clear. Okay. You prank call an Enclave soldier and just start shit talking the president on the line. It's great. So it's here, actually. It's these computer consoles that we can destroy. Yeah, it turns out we gotta break stuff. Let's see if this works. I'm gonna try and do this whole thing without alerting the Enclave. But this may or may not work. I'm really bad with these, so let's try this. I was expecting my inept handling to make it go off a lot earlier, but I guess we have a little time now, chat. One hour, 30 minutes is a long time to wait. There it is. There it goes. All right, you've destroyed the reactor, you've gone up a level, perfect. That is going to give us the ultimate perk. Which is Sniper. This is what we've been waiting the entire game for, chat. You mastered the firearm as a source of pain. With this perk, any successful hit in combat with a ranged weapon will be upgraded to a critical hit with a simple luck roll. So that means that pretty much everything we do with big guns is going to hurt really, 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 really bad. All right, we now have 10 minutes to get off the rig before, hello. We now have 10 minutes to get off the rig before the whole thing explodes. Real quick on the way out. By luck roll, I mean your luck stat. Of six, so 6 out of 10? Yeah, something like that. All right. I'm gonna provoke this guy. Oh, he doesn't have anything. Here, have a... Here, you wanna be sheriff? Oh, that didn't piss him off. Apparently you can do this. To get into a fight with the president without him. There we go. All right, you want the president dead? He's dead. Oh, I thought that was not gonna provoke them, but apparently it did. We need a thing off of him. This, the presidential access key. Oh, that's a big robot. All right, well, I was lied to by the FAQ. Let's see, those are the stairs I want to get to. Let's see how far we can get. Well, I just died. How much damage was that? Show me how much damage that was. That was 200 some. Jesus. Okay. I got another idea. I'm gonna blow myself up with this one. 30 seconds is not a long time. A sec. Just a moment. What is this thing for? Ah, okay. Let me see. Karimf, thank you for the follow. Let me see if I can get by without that. It does a specific thing that we might not need. Lord. And now the reactor is going up. All these people are going to die anyway, so. Go up here. Ah, okay, this took us around. Announcements of the reactor meltdown, everyone stands perfect. Well, look, this guy watched two people just literally explode in front of him and was like, okay, that's cool. Whatev. Hi, what's up? Halt, what are you doing here? Who are you? Sergeant Grant of EC Company. EC Company? Enclave Control Company, responsible for perimeter defense. Usually, that is. What do you mean, usually? You know, that freak Agent Oregon just stormed past here. He's waiting for someone to try and make a break for it. Who's that? He's some genetically engineered freak is what he is. Used to be the president's bodyguard. Secret Service Agent Frank Horrigan. Now he's more than half machine. Sounds like bad news. Oh, that he isn't worse. He's gonna mop up the floor with you. He's tough, fast, and just plain mean. I've seen what he likes to do to mutants, and it ain't pretty. Not a mutant, what'd he do? I don't like to talk about it. It gives me nightmares. Let's just say those walls aren't covered with rust exactly. Sounds like we're gonna have a hard time getting past him. It's the understatement of the year. I pity you, pal. I really do. Pity me. You should feel bad for yourself. Your power plant's control computer got fried. Now you're headed for a meltdown. You're all dead men unless... Unless what? Unless you help me get past Horrigan again to get my ship. Okay. I can't talk for everyone. My squad and I'll do our best to help you put that freak Horrigan away for good. I don't want to drown like no rat. All right, let's go get him. We got to get out of here. Okay, so, yeah, this is... Oh, shit. What do you shit. Want? Let's go.
You want
Hang
me
on.
Back now?
Yeah, let's head out. I need to get my party back before we do this.
What you be needing?
So this is like the this is the final boss of the game, essentially. This is Fallout 2's version of the master. And then that's 2mm EC. Yeah, here. You take that. Oh, apparently you just like the G11. All right, well, we'll see how this goes down. And then I should maybe, let's see. I'll switch to the Avenger for this. Yeah. Another mere caseless. I don't think a Power Fist is gonna help very much, so let's load. I think Armor Piercing is gonna be better for this. I think Armor Piercing is gonna be better for this. Schwunk. So that's him. Is this big ugly fucker. It's the guy that killed the Deathclaws in Vault 13. The guy who mulched those random people out in the desert. It's all him. And I'm actually wondering, can I use this? Users, presidential security override requires presidential only pass key options allowed, counterinsurgency, emergency defensive system shutdown. Counterinsurgency. In the event of armed rebellion, presidential security key card allows defensive systems to be turned on. Previously loyal but now threatening units within an area. Programmed to attack most dangerous foe first. Sounds useful. Okay, so you have to have, so that's what you, if you kill the president and you get his key card, you can use that option. We won't mess with that. Let's see. Oh, Marcus? Hey, Marcus. Real quick.
What do you want?
Let's put you back on ranged. And then, yeah, there we go. Okay. All right, I think we're about as ready for this as we can be. You're so funny, I don't die instantly.
You've gotten a lot farther than you should have, but then you haven't met Frank Horrigan either. Your ride's over, Muti. Time to die.
Frank who?
Me. Frank Horrigan, that's who. United States Secret Service. You aren't going anywhere from here.
I'm going past you whether you like it or not.
Making our reactor meltdown means that things are going to be pretty hot in here soon. Pity you won't live long enough to see it. You're not a hero. You're just a walking corpse.
Talk the talk. Can you walk the walk? I don't think so. What's he got? 16 hit points. 73. That didn't kill me. 10. Okay. Great. Awesome. Well, I had all of these for a reason. Let's hit him with a rocket. Let's see what that does. Forty-four hit points. Okay, great. Frank talks a big game for guys on a royal rig that's about to explode. Yeah. All right. Wait, who's shoot? Alright, so the turrets still shoot you if they're not shut down. So they're on Horrigan's side at the moment. Only one of us is walking away, and it might not be me! Can rockets crit? Not sure, actually. All right, and my friends are shooting the turrets and each other instead of Frank, so that's great. He's making some angry noises, at least. All right, so my buddies are trying to take out the turrets. That's cool. I'm hurting again. Yes, you can turn the turrets against him, but we'd have to kill the president to get his key card and then get out with, like, everyone in the base aggroed on us. I think as long as I don't die, this will be okay. It's obviously the most incisive thing I've ever said. How's he looking anyway? He looks wounded. You see a huge man-like creature glaring at you with a look of pure hatred. One time I beat him was by hacking the turrets. I think their ways stealthy eliminate the present. I tried one of those ways and it didn't work, so. Frank Horrigan was critically hit for 423 hit points. I think I got him. Now I just need the rest of these turrets to not kill me. There's apparently five of them. Oh wait, he got back up. Well, that sucks. How many hit points does he have? Well, I can do that again. Urf. Urf. How's he looking now? He looks almost dead, okay. So obviously gonna heal some more. It's not 20,000. There's no way to do 20,000 damage to anything in this game. I'm fairly confident he has less than 1,000. Cause he's almost dead after all of this that he's been through. That might be it. Oh, I think that's the end of... Oh, yeah, that's the end of him. Oh, God, that's the end of him. Okay, I didn't really expect it to go down like that, but sure. Torso phase, let's go. All right, we still gotta get rid of the turrets, though. Rub some apple pie on it, you'll be fine. Okay, that's one. Okay, there's still, I think there's four left. Wait, he's still moving. Oh, yeah, never mind. Okay. Yeah, we're good. Okay, I think there's two left now. Let me see here. 74%, 86. All right, that one's down. Can I hit this one? I did some damage to it, but I didn't kill it. That was an awesomely long day. He's in, that's probably the grossest death animation I've seen in this entire game. That was absolutely vile. Okay, we did it. All right, I got 11,400 experience points. Let's reload this, let's save. All right, I think we're good to go. Can I search him? No, I see the remains of Frank. He looks dead. He definitely looks dead. I think we did it, chat. Assuming everybody got themselves out of the detention block, I think we did it. So long, Mr. President. Been playing too much Resident Evil lately. Are you sure he's dead? It was a phase 2 boss fight on the top of the tanker. Oh, that would totally be a Resident Evil thing, yeah. His upper torso just climbs its way up the side of the tanker, and you have to fight him on the deck. War never changes, chat. It always ends with a big old mushroom cloud. Then Leon makes a joke. He really tried to top himself with that one. Grayscale explosions are weird.
After the Enclave's destruction, the refugees of Arroyo and Vault 13 resettled, building a new community with the aid of the Garden of Eden creation kit. Finding themselves hundreds of miles from their vault, the members of Vault 13 chose to join the villagers in establishing a new community, and their technical expertise, combined with the villagers' survival skills, allowed the new settlement to grow and prosper. Two generations of the same bloodline were reunited, and their savior, the Chosen One, became elder, presiding over the village in the years to come.
Yay for us!
Relations between the Slags and the residents of MODOK flourished. Between the two peoples, MODOK prospered and became a
this
major
was the,
farming
the
community,
ghost farm.
Supplying all the outlying regions with food. With Metzger gone, slavery disappeared from the area.
Yes! Down with slavery!
The casino bar grew quickly, and Rebecca Dyer's reputation as an honest casino and bar owner brought her the business needed to buy out her competition and expand.
Good for them,
the
I guess.
The game flourished, and it soon gained a reputation for being a tough
MODOK
but
prospers.
Honest community. In the years following the destruction of the Enclave, Vault City continued to stagnate, choking on its own isolationism. Its Vault 8 generator, which was never intended to support such a large population, prevented Vault City's necessary expansion. Eventually, the city was absorbed by NCR, which had spread...
I don't think there's a good end for Vault City, unless... Wait, no.
Within a year of the destruction, the Wright family turned from criminal activity to legitimate pursuits.
Hey, that worked out.
Several schools and churches were established in New Reno, along with a law enforcement body that crippled the influence of the families. Though New Reno lost much of its edge, the city obtained a certain solidity.
So killing everybody but the Wrights was actually a good end for New Reno.
Many came to Reno not to visit, but to live, and the population increased threefold.
Hey, good for
Today,
us.
The test scores of New Reno High School graduates are greater than many California schools before the war. Though the Wright family never completely recovered from Richard's death, the knowledge that their killer had been brought to justice eased their troubled sleep.
Nice.
Optimizing Gecko's reactor created a power surplus in Gecko. The Vault City Council, unable to expand because of their limited power supply, yielded to internal pressure and was forced to take over Gecko to control the reactor. The peaceful ghouls of Gecko became slaves.
Oh, that didn't work out.
Lives, serving Vault City.
That sucks. Several it doesn't really seem to mesh with the Vault City ending, though.
From the Chosen One, Marge LaBarge was able to purchase and control both the Morningstar and the newly opened Cocoa Weave mines. Marge was an easy choice for mayor, and using her new political power, she made Redding join the growing New California Republic in return for a seat in the NCR's Hall of Congress. With the destruction of the conspiracy to destroy the mutants, Broken Hills began to thrive.
Oh, good, okay.
Then, the uranium ran out.
Uh-oh.
The city, having lost its sole reason for existing, slowly dispersed. The residents carried their riches with them.
I think this is the best ending you can get for Broken Hills.
Desolate ghost town.
I think.
A few holdouts remained, attempting to eke out a pathetic existence. But eventually,
some of these might still be bugged.
They too disappeared. Your help with Vault 15 launched the New California Republic's push to civilize its neighbors. Though there were many more obstacles to overcome, the NCR now had a foothold into the northern wastes. With the support of the New California Republic, the Vault 15 squatters soon became self-sufficient and productive members of society.
I remember them.
By eliminating the death claws of Vault 13, you banished yet another species of the realms of extinction, proving once again
pretty sure this one's
genocide
bugged.
Is a viable solution to any problem. The Xi flourished, creating a botanical scourge on the radiation surrounding their beloved town. Though this vine could not grow in
Yeah, that's not
soils,
the right ending for that.
The Xi took care to nourish it in their lands. They continued to grow in strength and prominence, forming the basis of a new empire. As for the tanker vagrants, well, as vagrants do, they drifted on.
It's genocide, your way to victory, Soros Fallout 2.
Give me a kiss to build a dream on, and my imagination will thrive upon that kid.
The bug is that seeing the massacre causes that ending. Yeah, I think that, I think you end up with that ending if the Vault 13 Deathclaws die for any reason. So yeah, chat, this is actually like huge for me. I have never finished Fallout 2, and I will tell you why. I will tell you specifically why. The first, did you get Vault City joining the NCR? Yes. Yeah. I got, that one was weird because it said Vault City relying on their own reactor didn't have the power to expand. And eventually they were weakened to the point where NCR was able to take them over. But then later on the Gecko slide, it said that Vault City eventually took over Gecko, enslaved the ghouls, and claimed the reactor for themselves. Yeah, bored halfway through it stopped. Kinda. The first time I played through Fallout 2, I got pretty... I think I made it down to NCR and just kind of burned out on the game. I tried a couple other playthroughs that didn't get that far. And then finally, I think when I was in high school or college, I decided, okay, I am finally going to beat this game. And I'm gonna play, you know, I'm gonna play a character that I don't normally play. I think around that time, I'd also just finished like my evil playthrough of Fallout 1, and that one went incredibly smoothly. So I was like, okay, I'll play the same kind of character in this. I made a female amoral thief character. Really high stealth, really high stealing, and unarmed. I went all in on unarmed combat. She wasn't like super smart. I don't think she had like any charisma. But I could sneak around anything, I could steal anything. It was perfect, it was great, right? So I went through most of the game. I started to burn out on it again. I was like, okay, I'm just gonna finish this. I'm just gonna get done with this. So I ran through all the Vault 13 and San Francisco stuff just to finish it. I got to the Enclave rig. I don't think I had any party members. I don't think I took anybody with me. I ran through the Enclave rig. I triggered the meltdown. I went to leave. When I got to the end there, when I got to the grand finale, I was not charismatic enough to get Granite Company to help me. I was not smart enough to get the turrets working for me. I'm trying to remember if I even got the presidential passcode, but for whatever reason, I couldn't use the turrets. And because I went all in on unarmed, it was basically me by myself with a mega power fist against that motherfucker and like 8 turrets. It was impossible. I had accidentally designed a character that could not beat the game, even though I was in the I was on the final screen of it, so. I didn't play Fallout 2 for a long time after that. But with us streaming Fallout 1 to great accolade, I decided it was time since y'all were amenable to it, to finally go through and beat this one. And I did! I did it, chat, and everything went, for the most part, pretty smoothly. There is some stuff that I glossed over. I think... Well, I mean, I finished all the major quests, really. I think the big thing that I didn't do was the Sierra Army base. I think there's some really neat plot stuff that you can do that down there if you get in, but again, I didn't want to deal with those turrets. There's some other companions you can get that I didn't. Doesn't count, start over. Requirements: fix the power plant, kill the raiders, expose Bishop's plan, and deliver the two holodiscs, but do not collect the final reward from Randall. And both Roger West and Joanne Lynette are alive. Yeah, it's pretty complicated. That sounds like trying to get an ending in Fallout 1 where the Necropolis survives. There's some stuff in the endings of these games that just, either because they're bugged or they have really specific triggers, it's hard to get good endings for them. Yo, what I miss? Nothing. It's nothing. Yeah, we're just hanging out. We're just chatting. There was some stuff going on, but yeah, it's fine. So, this character was admittedly slow going at the beginning. I didn't really build them as an unarmed character, so they kind of struggled early on. Once I had some solid allies, and armor, it went better. But yeah, it really didn't take off until I got a big gun. And I know for optimal big gun builds, they suggest making a character that can get into the toxic caves and get the Bozar from there right at the beginning. Because then you're pretty much set as far as a weapon for the vast majority of the game. Oh hey, if you're wondering about the voice cast, this is who all your favorite characters were. Charlie Adler, Ron Perlman, Dwight Schultz, Jason Marsden, Bree Summer, Kevin Michael Richardson, Peter Jason, also Peter Jason. Lo Dyer? Interesting. Tress McNeil, Greg Eagles, Michael Dorn, of course. I thought he was also Frank Horrigan. They had a bunch of modulation on his voice, but yeah. Jeffrey Jones is the president of the United States of America. See ya, chat. After playing through all the way through this again, I feel like Fallout 2 is at once a more complete but more uneven experience than Fallout 1 is. Like Fallout 1 is very tight, it's very focused, it's really kind of linear in a way, because it's a bit hard unless you know exactly what you're doing to break sequence in that one. And not just get absolutely murdered by things. But it tells a very coherent story. It does it with some pretty decent pacing. This one, I feel like they tried so hard to like go wide on this one and make like a big, huge world. And it definitely paid off, because a lot of the areas, especially all the big towns in the middle of the map, Redding, New Reno, certainly, Broken Hills, Vault City, NCR, San Francisco. They had like a ton of stuff to do. Like, I think a lot of the nights we spent, like we spent at least one night on most of the big locations. But at the same time, it was very obvious that different locations were written and designed by different people. Like, some of them sounded really, like, even your own character sounded different in different locations. Okay, fine, if you really must. What is this? Did you find the extra special encounters? We got one. We got the bridge, but there are several in this game. And they're even more specialer than the ones in Fallout 1. Keep looking. But yeah, it was weird. Different locations in this game have different tones. The quests have different flows to them. It's interesting for variety's sake, but in terms of like a cohesive narrative, it's not quite as solid. And of course, the fact that we made it to like the maybe you'll find the Maltese Falcon. Isn't there a Wing Commander reference? I think there is. Is that Fallout? I think it's this one, actually. I think Fallout 1 has the crashed Star Trek shuttle. If I remember correctly. We're just fucking around here now. But yeah, y'all noticed at the very ending of this epic story, we were able to convince the lead genocider to genocide his own people instead of the people he was going to genocide. I think some of the later areas were rushed. Do you wish you can play? Yeah, hell yes, I do. So we don't necessarily have to wrap up just yet, chat. We got some other stuff that we can do here. Some unique dialogue if you go back to certain places. The main thing I want to do is like run around in the desert and see if we can get some of those special encounters. Tell you where I have some fun Easter eggs if you want. Yeah, sure, hit me. Cause I want to do some wandering anyway. So while we're tooling around looking for, did they? Oh no, I think you actually. Okay. I know there's one thing you can do. Go back to New Reno and talk to Father Tully. Okay, let's try that. Let's go do that. I may have missed the stream. Did we finish up? We almost finished Reno. We completed all the quests for the Salvatores and the Mordinos, and then we killed both of them. We showed up to the bishop's place and killed the bishops. We almost finished all the missions for the rites. I never finished the final one, which was to get into the Sierra Army base, because I didn't get in there. Miss Kitty in New Reno, Lynette in Vault City. Okay. So let's head. Let's see, where's New Reno? There's New Reno. We'll head up there first. What the fuck? That nasty bunion on each foot seems to have turned into extra toe, but at least that persistent burning itch has gone away. Could always check out the army base. I suppose that's true too. Aliens! By the way, where am I? Oh, I'm still level 24. 9,000 away from 25. I guess we can just leave. I don't give a shit about you anymore. Nice shot. I can't believe it wouldn't use my fucking Gauss rifle. Nice shooting, Cass. Jesus Christ. Let's see. Miss Kitty was on this street, right? Yeah, cat's paw. Hey, As the species looks up startled, you came back. I thought you might be dead. I was so worried, risking your life to take on the Enclave. That's the bravest thing I ever heard. Shucks, Miss Kitty. Tain't nothing nobody else wouldn't have done in my place. You're so humble. I love that about you. Makes sweeping gesture of the cat's paw. You're always welcome here, free of charge. Thanks. I appreciate it. Bye. Oh, God. So I guess the Desperado is just like a blood-soaked ruin now. Bartenders in the arena treat you differently. We'd have to find one that's still alive. That might be a little tricky. Oh, I could actually finish my career as a boxer. I never did that. I totally forgot to go back on that one. Yeah, Salvatore's bar is... Oh, there's a few patrons here. Just sitting in the empty building by themselves. Oh, I'm not sure I have any booze. Hopefully you don't need it for Balotelli. How are you? Don't know you. You're the... Be the Enclave. A guy hero. Tangle the Enclave. Yes, they started it. I finished it. But don't get me wrong, Father. I'm just a man trying to make his way in this unforgiving world. I'm no hero. You're a hero. I got something for you. I don't know what it was at first, but I figure you might be needing it. Sure. I'll take whatever you're giving, Father. Within the realms of decency. Tully goes over one of the pews, rips off a board from the seat, and pulls a grimy softcover book. Here you go, it's a little dirty, but thanks, I think. You're here, you deserve it. Not many gamers today finish games, but you went the distance. I'm proud of you. All the new Reno is proud of you. Thanks, you take care of yourself. You hear that, chat? Not many gamers actually finish. You see the Fallout 2 hitbook. Well, this would have been good to have at the beginning of the game. Apparently all the Hobologist endings involve their plan going wrong and them all dying. Understood, does it mean we're gamers? Yes, we are capital G gamers now. I think this actually does something. Yeah, it does. It does, it does, it does. You gain 10,000 experience points. The book contains tons of insider information on Fallout 2, more than enough to modify yourself for the better. Yeah, I think this is the free level up book. Oh my god, all my stats were set to 300. I don't think I can... Yeah. So all of my skills are at max level now. Completely. Okay, well that's gonna make some things easier to do. Time to break some computer terminals. Okay, the thing I really wanna do. The thing I really, 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 really wanna do is I wanna get, actually we can just leave now that I think about it. The thing that I really super wanna do is get some of those special desert encounters. And with Outdoorsman 300, I think it should be pretty easy to... Is there an exit? I'm sorry, is there... Can you just give me a map of where I am right now? No, apparently not. Okay, whatever. Oh, there's a literal map button. I'm an idiot. Okay, south of here is the exit grid. Due south, that's right. All right, so let's see if we can find some of these. The bridge was one of them. I think having a higher outdoorsman skill increases the odds of encounters being like special ones. If it doesn't, we might just have to drive around the wasteland for a bit. Well, that's not it. I don't want fire geckos. Fuck off. I tell you what, we'll go hop in the car. And we'll drive around. I'll drive up to Oh, my shit's still here. Nobody stole my shit somehow. Post game time to go for the dick punches. Let's drive up to Vault City and see what Lynette has to say. I do not wish to encounter some mobsters now. I wish to encounter some cool shit. Give me some cool shit, game. That's not cool shit. No, I don't want to encounter a pack of wolves. Band of slavers and some dogs, no. I'd kill the slavers, but I'd probably end up killing the dogs, too. Alright, hang on.
What do you want?
I need you to wait here, because these guys are racist pieces of shit. What time is it? Oh, it's 5 in the morning. Fuck. Hang on, I gotta wait in the courtyard. There we go. You're welcome to stay in Vault City as long as you... Well, thanks. Thanks. I don't suppose you have anything new to say, do you? Hey, glad you made it back. Last I heard you were traveling down south, gunning up old tankers and blowing up old oil derricks. You come back here for a little peace and quiet, Mr. Big Hero? I come back and touch base with Vault City for a while. Peace and quiet doesn't hurt either. I need something first. Yeah, that's fine. So yeah, you do get little bits of new dialogue for some folks. Val or Valerie or whatever. I wonder if Marcus would have something to say about this if we hadn't recruited him. You have anything new to say? Oh, you're about your act of heroism. We are all in your debt. Wow, people actually call you Chosen One now.
Word of your brave deed has traveled quickly. Is it true? Was the government still waging the war?
Apparently the Energy Weapons Skill Book is a cat's paw magazine that has a really good article on guns. Yes, they're going to use a virus to exterminate all life. They plan to start over at the cost of all that you've built here.
How callous. How cruel. Were they not aware of the community we had built here?
Perhaps an important lesson can be learned here, Lynette. Isolated from the world, the government was prepared to destroy you without even recognizing the value of your community. Perhaps Vault City should take another look at the outside world and its place in it.
That may be a valid point. Next time we should make a stronger effort to find these remnants of the government and ally ourselves with them. I hear they have great power armor.
forget it. Good luck.
Please, call me Lynette. Travel carefully, my friend. We shall never forget you. You shall always have a home here within the walls of Vault City.
Thanks, Lynette. Oh, I should probably roll down to NCR. I bet Tandy has something to say. I mean, that is like quintessential Vault City. Like, that is why Vault City inevitably fails, because they just can't see the bigger picture. Sucks, but you just can't get through to some people, and that's the unfortunate truth.
Stupid.
Come on, big man.
What do you want? You want me back now?
Let's see. Is Arroyo still destroyed, or can we? I mean, I might as well check, right? Let's fill in some map while we're here. You want to encounter a merchant party? Nah, that's cool. Do you want to? Oh shit! Do you wish to encounter a band of ruffians led by Morton, brother? Yeah, remember? You killed my brother. Now I'll kill you. Yeah, I don't really see that happening. If we're being honest here for a second, Mr. Frogman. Yeah, you're kind of dead now. You ever had a knuckle sandwich? I don't. What? What? This seems like such a waste, though. I saw the Bozar. Uh-oh. That's unfortunate. Big gun thug. Okay. Okay. Yeah, you're dead. My guys are sequencing really fast. Oh, I took too many... Fuck, I took too many steps. Well, I better get out of their way, then. Y'all can handle this. Okay, yep, that's you. All right then, well, what'd the Morton have on him? An HK cause, that's not bad. What did Big Gun Thug? Oh, no, not you. Big Gun Thug. Big Chungus Thug. Oh my God, she had a flamer. That's cool. Gun Thug had a combat shotgun. All right. Those pistols always look really intimidating, yet I don't think I've ever used one in this game. Not one of those, anyway. Okay, Arroyo hasn't been reconstructed yet. So let me fuel the car back up and we'll head down for the Sierra Outpost. Maybe I can actually accomplish something there now. I'll shoot some missiles at some turrets. Oh no. We don't wanna go yet. We wanna gas her up. Shove some of that in there. Shove some more of that in there. Did I shove all of that? I shoved all of that in there. Okay, great. All right. There's the Sierra Depot. No red scorpions, thank you. No wolves, thank you. All right, I'm not gonna need my punchy stuff.
Hello?
Huh. She saw me. Alright, that's one down. Are we talking about this one? Alright, that's another one down. Alright, we're clear at the moment. Alright, I think we take out those two and maybe that one. So when's Fallout 3? Not for a very long time, I don't think. If ever. He has a trap in the door. I don't care. Just open it. Oh, well, I have traps 300, so it doesn't actually matter. Since we're here. Since I have everything 300. I guess I could just sneak around now if I wanted. When's Fallout Shelter? Definitely never. I thoroughly ruined Fallout Shelter for myself. I played it back when it came out with an unpatched exploit that let you just have as many of those like loot box lunch boxes as you wanted. So I had a completely tricked out settlement and got really bored with it and never went back. How'd you get everything to 300? I got the official Fallout 2 hint book. Which would have been real good to have at the beginning of the goddamn game. If you use this, it gives you 10,000 experience and it maxes all of your skills. It's purely post-game. You have to go to a character after you beat the game to get it. Alright, anyway, let's get this thing going. Guy, you dumbasses. Hopefully this doesn't kill you. Alright, that blew open the door. So now we can get in just as soon. Just as soon as we take care of these turrets. Between Sulik, Cassidy, and Marcus, who will you kill first? I imagine Cassidy's probably gonna be the first one to go down. With whatever we're doing. All right, Sierra Army Base. The one place we really didn't go in this game. It looks pretty unoccupied. And kind of green. An active computer terminal, okay. Skynet, security checkpoint 1, please enter password. Hack into security systems. Pressing Control-Alt-C causes the program to crash. You have the rest of the security measures. They're this easy to defeat. What do we got here? A retinal scanner. Also, I saw some... Okay, here's an elevator. I saw something going on over here. thought I did anyway. There's a bunch of lockers back here. Let's see what those are. Where are we had to step out? I'm checking out the Sierra Army base in the post game. Since this is like the one major area we never made it to. Guns. So let's just put that up. I'll re-equip my power fist. That way I don't have to keep putting my minigun away every time I want to check a locker. Bullets. Assault rifle. Combat armor. That would have been nice. Of course, I mean, you need to be at least that armored to get in here without getting mulched, so... Retinal scanner. Really? That's a fuckload of robots, too. That's like all the goddamn robots. I'm getting probed. I definitely didn't mean for this to happen. And you know what? I think I realized what I screwed up. Please stop taking turns. Biomed gel. I think I needed this. I think there was like an eyeball I could have used on this to not get all caught up by these guys. God, this is gonna take forever. I don't wanna get probed. Thanks! Thanks for that. Cool, okay. Great. The humanoid must not escape. If I can just avenge these guys real quick, or vindicate. I need to vindicate these guys. Marcus is avenging, I'm vindicating. All right, I think that got... Yeah, that got both of them. Perfect. I think Marcus really wants to punch that guy. I can't hit him anyway. Okay. That's fine. Ow. I don't think he equipped his power fist. Smash the sensors. Oh, just die already. Yeah, bye. Picked a fight with the wrong bastard. What are y'all doing? Dude, don't make me shoot him. Don't make me waste bullets on this guy. Downloading escape program. Oh my god. Fine. I'm not gonna miss Fallout's combat system. That's for goddamn sure. I'm pretty much out of bullets for this thing too. Is there any neat stuff in here, or no, it doesn't really look like it. Can I open this now? Since I tipped off the security system, can I just go? A new retina pattern, okay. Yeah, I think I need that biomed gel. Jar of biomed gel used in the biomedical field. Did somebody leave an eyeball laying around here somewhere? There's the yellow memory module. Ah, here we go. Dixon's eye and a tape. It's a medical holodisc. What's this all about? Sierra Depot medical log. Infirmary attending physician Dr. Solomon, subject Corporal Dixon. Subject was attempting to arm an attack mine in storage bay as part of Sierra Army Depot's evacuation defenses. Mine detonated prematurely, severely injuring Corporal Dixon and General Clifton. Corporal Dixon suffered severe lacerations of hand, chest, and... Okay. Experiment. So they were experimenting with this biomed gel to, like, stabilize... Oh, there's wall lockers here. To stabilize severe injuries in such situations. I should have known, chat. I should have known to check the lockers for eyeballs that I could shove into the elevator instead of just blindly touching it like a fool. Here, I have an eyeball. Place three floors, it looks like. Floor two. Looks like big time storage. Oh my sweet baby Jesus. That is a lot of security robots. That is a lot of security robots. There's a computer terminal down there. How about no? And then real quick, let's see. Yeah. Let's see if there's a... If it ends on three or if it goes further down. It goes for... God Christ, it goes further down. Okay. This place is pretty big. There's quite a bit going on here, and there's that other elevator, so. All right, chat, I think I'm gonna go ahead and stop here. I don't really feel the need to explore the rest of the Sierra Army base. I was just curious what was down here. There is a supercomputer in here that you can talk to, like the supercomputer in the glow in Fallout 1. But I will leave that for y'all to do. I will leave that for y'all to check out if you're so inclined, so. Anyway, chat, we did it! Fallout 2 is complete. Fallout 2 is over. We saw the credits and I didn't even have to push this big credit button. And let me just say how perfect I think it is that it took us exactly 13 streams to do Fallout 2. Just like the holy 13. So. To recap everything that is happening this week, to celebrate the completion of Fallout 2, I'm going to try Fallout Tactics tomorrow night. I can't wait to see how this goes. If it sucks really bad, I have something even worse we can play. But don't worry, because on Wednesday, we're going to be playing another hidden object game. So if you had a really, really good time coming out for Infected the Twin Vaccine, you'll have a good time on Wednesday, don't worry. We are hopefully, finally going to finish the current issue of Nintendo Power on Thursday, which means sparring with Bob and George. Jesus Christ. Friday is going to be the wheel this week. We're doing a Next Fest demo wheel. So if you see a cool Next Fest demo that you think I should try on Friday, by all means, throw it up there with your dragon coins. One demo per person, of course. Saturday, assuming we finish Nintendo Power on Thursday, on Saturday we should be starting Final Fantasy Mystic Quest. So if you're mainly out here for RPG goodness, that is admittedly a very different speed RPG, but should still fit the bill. And as the bot just helpfully reminded us, we are now voting on what we're going to start next week, 1 week from tonight, as our next big game, because I'm itching to do something. Will it be more Zelda? Will we be trying out RimWorld? Are we finally going to do Dark Souls or Thief 3? Will you go in on some of the other options? I don't know. We'll find out together. But for tonight, chat, I think that is it. Final Fantasy Mystic Quest is an RPG in the same way that miniature golf is still golf. True. True. And I often find myself enjoying miniature golf more than real golf. So hopefully that works out the same way here. Anyway, let's go find somebody to go raid. Dark Souls, ever the bridesmaid. How about... Oh, I think Blue Zest is doing their own sort of demo night. They're playing the demo for Xenonauts 2, and I'm kind of curious about this one, so let's go hang out with them for a bit. To be fair, mini golf is the only real kind of golf. It's the only ethical kind of golf. How about that? Anyway, chat, thank you so much for joining me on this journey. I am so happy to have finally beaten Fallout 2. And not just oddish beaten, I have genuinely beaten it. And I am really, really happy about this. And I'm glad people really enjoyed it, too. I'm glad that for once we were able to go straight from one game to its sequel. I'm glad that we were able to play two CRPGs back to back to completion. That's not really something I ever thought about doing on this channel, but again, seems to have worked out. And I'm glad I could share the origins of the Fallout series with you, because as much as I like the Bethesda Fallouts, they kind of lose some of this magic, I think. Now that I've revisited them, I definitely prefer, these original two to the ones that came later. Who knows? We may still stream Fallout 3, New Vegas, even 4 maybe in the future, but I don't think it's going to be for a while. We got plenty of other stuff to do in the interim. So hopefully I will see you all tomorrow night for just a little bit more Fallout, just a tiny bit more in Fallout Tactics. But until then, as always, y'all take care. Bye, everybody.